Howdy, this is Review 64. I'm doing another review for you. Second review. This is the Iron Man Mark III, which is pretty much the Iron Man we all know. Finished product, if you will. We have the figure. It's nicely detailed. It's a very smooth figure. It's a nice addition to the actual movie. I've compared it with promotional advertisements and trailers, and it matches up pretty well. It's not over detailed. Marvel Legends and 6-inch scales normally aren't, but you know, it gets like Ironmonger. It gets the same feel of the movie character into the figure. I like it. It possesses pretty much the same articulation as any other Hasbro Marvel Legend, with the exception of the joints in the hand. I don't think it really needed it, you know, because it has a really nice sculpt to both the hands. Wait, let's see. You know, they're pretty nice. They're very hand-like. Okay, now, the color scheme, okay? Basic Iron Man. See, I think this is really the best Iron Man that's been out in the last decade, at least. You know, they had a good model to work off of the movie. The movie Iron Man. Really nice. Like I said, it's very true to the movie figure. A lot of the other Iron Mans that have been coming out, they make this new modern Iron Man, I think. It's cool, but I don't think it's as cool as this figure. It looks over-articulated in that it kind of looks bulky, and I've heard that armor restricts some of the articulation, and, you know, you never like that. Also, the, like, Hasbro Marvel Legends, I think Series 1, they had one, and everybody said it was really dull. It was pretty much like this gray and red figure. It's really bad. But anyway, yeah, this is a really nice figure. No joke. Like, another little bonus to it. On the back, it's, like I said, it's really detailed, but, like, it forms downward. And, like, since Iron Man is a person who can fly robotic suit, it'd have to be really aerodynamic, and it really reflects in the figure. It's really smooth. It makes a lot of sense. If a robot could fly, this is what it would look like. And it's nice. You know, I like it. In this line, they have been trying to put action into action figure and giving them missiles or little action-packed things like removable armor or, you know, just like an Ironmonger. They had Super Fish Smash, which was, you know, pretty much flopping around with squeezing the legs together. But, I like the idea, no joke, okay, but, this one is a plastic, let's see, it's called a launching repulsor blast, which is pretty much just, you know, a launch projectile piece of plastic. You know, it's nice, it fits onto the figure very well, like, it just works it way up and it can sit there pretty well. I like it. Like I said, I just like the whole idea of putting action into action figure. I wish they would do that with their Hasbro Marvel Legends, because it seems like the only action part of the figure is like a removable helmet, and the Build-A-Figure piece, but, you know, that's not as good as a launching piece of plastic. Well, again, here's the figure. Like I said, it possesses the same articulation of a Hasbro Marvel Legend. I think it's slightly more detailed than just a basic Marvel Legend. I recommend it. If you're gonna get any of these figures, get this one. First of all, it's the main character. Second of all, I mean, they have four of pretty much the same figure. They have, like, the Walmart exclusive Stealth Iron Man. They have Target exclusive, like, Silver Iron Man. And they have, like, They have one more, Mark II, and they're all the same figure, except with different paints or added missiles. But I recommend this one the best. First of all, is, you know, Iron Man, classic colors, classic detail, nice. Okay, I'll do the packaging very quickly. I did it with the Ironmonger. I just want to do it again for Iron Man. It has popping out letters giving dimension to the actual packaging. Like I said, they just caught my eye. I like them. In the back, it shows the figure. It shows how to use its projectile. It has a bio and an overall line bio. Also, at the bottom, it shows other figures within the line and visit Hasbro.com right here. One thing that I thought was actually funny about this, you see that character, oh wait, no, on the other side, see that, oh wait, glare, okay, well, there's this figure, and it's Ironmonger, and it shows his face, and on Toy Fair 08, I was looking at pictures of Hasbro, you know, Iron Man, and they actually taped over it, because it is telling who is actually driving Ironmonger, and yeah, I just thought that was funny that they made that big of a mistake. But you can't find him anywhere. You can't find the armor off Ironmonger or Titanium Man. And I don't like that because I love Titanium Man. But anyway, here he is again. Like I said, really nice detailing. I recommend him. And this is Review 64 signing out.